Hello, my name is Nitin. SPR has issued a new application note on time average specific absorption rate assessment that describes how to assess devices with dynamic power control and exposure time averaging algorithm, or in short DPC-ETA, using DASY 6 or DASY 8 when you don't have access to manufacturer tools. So today, let's quickly check the accuracy and convenience of applying the procedure of this application note together with DASY's time average SAR feature. The test will be conducted using the DPC-ETA enabled commercial mobile phone at the mid channel for LTE band 2 at 50% RB QPSK modulation. The phone is mounted with a 10mm spacer on the flat phantom in the back position. The DASY 6 measurement includes a fast area scan and a zoom scan, followed by a time average scan anchored to the peak location identified in the zoom scan. The averaging duration is set to 300 seconds. The device under test uses an averaging window of 100 seconds, which means that we will see three averaging periods in the results. I run the project. DASY 6 controls the base station simulator to set up the call. Before proceeding with the actual area or zoom scan, the duty output power is set to PREF of 13 dBm by manually adjusting the max allowed power PMAX parameter in the CMW500 base station simulator window. At this power level, the DPC-ETA control stops actively adjusting the uplink power when it is lowered to such a low value, and the output power of the device becomes constant. This can also be quickly verified. I now start the area and zoom scans and accelerate the video. Once the area and zoom scans are complete, DASY 6 prompts the user to activate the power monitoring algorithm. Here, I increase the BSS max allowed power to Pmax of 24 dBm, and this forces the DPC-ETA algorithm to actively adjust the power. The DPC-ETA control can be monitored in real time while the measurement is running using the multimeter view. At the end of the measurement, the time average SAR results are shown in the DASY window. This is indeed a very simple, straightforward and accurate method to assess the time average SAR with DASY 6 or 8 for devices that feature exposure time averaging when the manufacturer tools are not available. It becomes even easier if a CSAR 3D unit with software version 5 is also available. Thanks for watching this video.